Art appreciation is one of many ways to refresh the mind and spirit. The Pinto Gallery in Antipolo is a haven where art lovers can indulge in sprawling exhibition spaces.
Derived from the Filipino word pinto, which means door, the gallery is literally a doorway into the world of contemporary art.
Like wandering through a magical world, art pieces appear in every nook and cranny.
Deletion! Just kidding. It's actually called Defiling a Dream. And if you look at it simply, to me, it's a unicorn. As you all know, unicorns are magical beings that usually come out in dreams with beautiful maidens, and yet this one has reins and is controlled. So I guess that's sort of the meaning behind it. That's a Karen take on it. What?
Okay, so I may not be an art expert and I could easily lose myself in this wonderland. But luckily I have artist and museum guide Andy Orenshaw to lead me through the maze. Once the private collection of art patron Dr. Joven Kuanang, the gallery is now home to hundreds of works by Filipino artists.
Tell me about this room specifically.
So this room is actually, it's all about the Saling Pusa.
Okay.
And the Saling Pusa started in the early 90s, invite kami ni Dr. Kuanang para magamit namin yung place niya, yung space niya. And then from here, we have the project, the Carnival, and then later on, all these members came up with solo or group exhibits, and then later, it paved way to Pinto Art Museum.
And so all of these are the different artists?
Yes, exactly.
Right. Okay, so now we're going to be moving on to the next exhibit.
Yes,
right?
To the next exhibit.
So this actually caught my eye earlier, the specific painting. Who's it by?
It's by Chris Villanueva, and he did a painful work here because as you see, the details, it looks more like a bubble wrap taken from Rembrandt's painting, The Storm.
So it's really taking a classical and then putting on something
that's
a contemporary part.
Yes, that's right.
Yeah. Now, this other piece that we have here, what is it?
This is by Marcus Tignani. Okay. And Marcus Tignani is also the one who came up with the idea of Carnival, along with Karen Flores. And this is the gambling version of The Last Supper.
It's very Pinoy.
Very, very Pinoy.
All right, so let's continue on.
Yep.
So this looks like a very interesting piece.
Yes, because this is interactive mixed media. Now, the artist incorporates lights, photographs, and painting into one. And there's also a sensor.
So when you wave your hand.
Yes. It actually.
And the press.
Press.
And you have your lights.
You have the lights.
That's so cool. It actually gives a whole new meaning. So being quiet in a gallery.
Yes, that's right. It's like the inner garden natin.
Yeah. And,
this is a break, actually, from the two galleries that we
But it's an art through. In itself. It's natural art.
Yes. Talagang sinunog yung terrain and then pinreserve pa natin yung mga face.
Yeah.
And yun yung nakakatuwa dahil very natural yung flow.
And also I noticed, of course, there's a breeze.
Yes.
Now, a lot of the times when we see in museum, they're hidden under glass.
Right.
How come for this one it's out?
Siguro ang gusto na sabihin ni Dr. Kuan, na nakapag-collect tayo ng painting, sinasabit natin sa bahay, so the same ambience without the aircon and without all this paper-serving painting, it goes the same with this museum.
And I would say it also gives it more of a, I guess a casual approach to art. Because there are sometimes we get so intimidated, and then you're a little afraid because they say, you know, you can't go too close to it. And this one, you can really see it down to the texture of everything. I didn't expect this place to take me on a journey through its doors that not only opened my creative expression, but also my mind and my heart to Filipino artistry. Vibrant,
dynamic,
and definitely inspiring. That's the current state of the art around the metro.
That's a roundup on the highlight this week. Join us again next time for another exploration of life and leisure
right here on Listed.